It's time to fire this thing up. What you're looking at is the shoreline to my camp up here in the middle of the Adirondack Park, located in upstate New York. Hey, well, good deal you made it. Hi, I'm John Graviscus. It's great to have you back aboard the boat with us. What I'm on is our model year 2009. This is a 16-foot Alumacraft. And we recently put this outboard engine on it. It's put out by Evinrude. It's a 25 horse and it is a tiller. What I like about it is we have a battery and I have electric trim, okay, which is very, very nice. And what I'd really like to have, since I have a battery, is I'd like to have some type of a way to read the bottom. There's a lot of great freshwater fishing here in Tupper Lake. There's lake trout, there's landlocked salmon, there's northern pike, walleye, bass, man, it is crazy. And that's what we're gonna be kind of getting into today here at Shipshape TV. We're gonna be looking at the difference between analog technology with fish finders and something called HD digital, all right? Now, transducers are very important when you're talking about freshwater fishing, and Airmar has created a new one for freshwater guys like us. And this is really cool. This is actually a transducer that you can rotate. It has a narrow fan beam, so you can point it forward and you can really see what's going on in front of the boat as well as what's going on behind. Or you can turn it 90 degrees so that when you're slow trolling, like I am right now, okay, trying to catch a fish, or if you're in shallow water, it really gives you a lot more coverage area and that gives you a better chance of catching fish, okay? Now up here in the Northwoods, as well as around the Great Lakes, all kinds of areas around the country, spiders are a real issue. And if you start getting spiders in your boat, they start putting droppings down, they can really stain the boat. We're gonna be learning about a very cool, environmentally friendly product today that doesn't kill them, all right? It just kind of skirts them away, keeps them out of the boat. But guess what? Before we can get into any of this stuff, shoot, you know the drill by now. You see, we need to work out a little trade-off. We've got to get all of you to spend the next 30 minutes with us as we're working and playing and fishing right here along the beautiful water's edge. And then in exchange, with again the help of a few of my very knowledgeable friends in the marine industry, we're all going to be pooling together in order to do our very best to let you in on a few more ways to make your boat shipshape. I really wish I knew how deep this water was. I want to catch a northern pike. It'd be awesome.